Brooklyn mother and Supreme 10 said it was somewhere around his house or somewhere around his way. Brooklyn mother shot son to death in Crown Heights during an argument over booze and weed. That's what the neighbor said. You can't make this shit up.
Mama was a pimp, you know what I'm saying? So me and my sister was raised around whores and crack pipes, and this is what you seeing, this is what you finding, is gunshots going on. I thought it was normal. Say, I'm not gonna ever try to manipulate no situations to f- my kids up.
I don't.
You do.
No, I don't.
You
I
do.
Tell your truth.
But you're not, it's not on you to tell my truth. That you tell your own damn truth. You don't even know
I
all
don't
my
care,
truth.
Don't you,
you don't
ever
even
talk
know
to
all my
like
truth.
That.
You don't even know all
but
my truth.
But you don't
truth.
Talk to me like
I talk,
that.
I talk with respect. I'm
no,
saying
you
all
don't.
This
you
with
just
respect.
Go
I said,
I'm gonna sit right here.
Like I'm talking to some way, I'm being a man. She not respecting me as a man because she's telling me you can't talk like you can't say that.
Who you?
No, if you don't give respect, you don't get it. I don't care who you are.
At first, I thought that this guy's pullout game is remarkably weak, but no, he's planning on having more kids, and it seems as though he equates being able to take care of them as the reason is why he should keep on doing this. Sir, taking care of children is not just a monetary thing. It's time. It's presence. It's lessons that you have to reiterate into their minds as they come of age. Even if you had all of your time dedicated to taking care of your kids, let's say that was your job, let's say that was your work, with 14, you still would not have enough time. You, my friend, are a blithering idiot. But let's see what else that he has to say.
I got the mamas and the babies. You feel me, son? I all got different baby mamas. I got all them too, you feel me? I'm on some boss shit, you feel me? I told you I'm preening this shit, real for real.
That's a lot of mouths to feed, bro.
I ain't tripping. I'm preening this shit.
Yeah.
Yep, this guy is an official bozo. Somehow it's implanted within his mind. The larger the corral of women that he has that he gets to impregnate, the much more masculine or much more defined in his manhood that he is. Men, listen to me. Stop defining your manhood with your eggplant. Your masculinity goes far deeper than what you can do with your pogo stick. But the incredibly short-sightedness of this is that I'm going to assume that none of these 14 women have him on child support. But at the moment that something goes wrong, they will put you on child support. And then you are dead broke. But just like I said, he's a bozo. So are all of the women that are in his stable. Like, think about, like, women 3 through 14 plus, right? Maybe not woman 1 and 2. You get a pass. Y'all two get a pass. But women 3 through 14, what is going through your minds? Like, you're seeing a dude that just... it's creating babies after creating babies, and you say, well, you know, I'm just going to be another one that creates a baby with him because, you know, at the end of the day, I want to be tied to him because he might make a lot more money in the future, but then also, babies are cool. And thus, the cycle continues. For the life of me, I can't understand why he's over here laughing and kikiing and shit from a situation as serious as this, because although you're watching him and all of these women around him, in my mind, I think of the kids, because kids are not playthings, because you cannot be a father to all of them. They're gonna suffer the ill-fated consequences of not having a father present, thus increasing the chances of them becoming a statistic. So to me, this shit is not funny, but this is what they call the culture. Y'all need to stop with all this foolishness.
Quayla Ann.
Now you told me to add you in the comments. How do you say
get out? Get out.
Who's that?
I'm trying to find you a stepdaddy.
Who is that? Your child?
That's my baby.
How old is your son?
No, that's my little girl. She's 8. Okay. I have 8 children. Well, 7.
How old are you?
I'm 26.
You really have 7 children?
I might just need a sugar daddy.
So listen, I don't got time for games. Are you here for the show or are you here to play games? Because I hang up on you.
I'm for real though.
So I want to just make sure. So you really have 7 children?
Yes, I have 7.
Okay. So what's your name, honey?
I'm Quayla.
Quayla, where you calling me from?
You said what?
Where are you calling me from?
I'm calling from Texas.
Texas? What part?
Dallas.
Dallas. And how old are you?
I'm 26.
26. How old are your kids?
I have an 8-year-old, a 7-year-old, 2 3-year-olds, 1-year-old,
so your 3-year-olds and 11-year-old. Your 3-year-olds are triplets?
Yes. No, they're twins.
You say you have 3 3-year-olds.
I have 2 3-year-olds.
Okay, so start from the top again.
Okay, I have 11-year-old, 2 3-year-olds, a 7-year-old, a 8-year-old, a 1-year-old, and that's only 6. I'm missing somebody. Oh, and a 5-year-old, Logan. Somebody said she's.
I don't got time. She could have been. I don't have time. No. How you forget your kids? Men have done that. Men have done that. She could have been serious.
I just can't. Ooh, my eyelashes look funny looking, but I don't care. Because people really thought I was trolling. I don't be trolling, I'm for real. I'm over here on the internet trying to look for the kids. A stepdaddy.
I wish I could find a man who could swoop in like a superhero and save me from, you know, work. Like a superhero and save me.
It's okay. I'm just never gonna have my man. And people always be thinking I'm playing. Like, I'm not playing. I own my own business. I got my own house. I got my own car. I take good care of all 7 of my children. It's not my fault that the dudes that I be with, they don't be on the same thing that I'm on, and I be having to leave, you know? I'm trying to build an empire, you know? Come on, come on, come on, baby. It's okay. Mama gonna find you a good daddy one day. You might be 18, but... I'm gonna go.
Nah.
Is there like a rule that you have? Like, okay, I'm gonna mess with this girl with
condoms. Nah, my first 4 or 5 came, like, I ain't, like, all, like, my first 5 came, they came quick. I was young, you know, I wasn't strapping up. 3 of them was my girlfriend, so I had 3 girlfriends at one time.
Wait, you had 3 girlfriends at one time?
Yeah.
Okay, so 3 of them, or the first 3 came with your girlfriends at the same time?
Now, I had 3 girlfriends. I had Nita, I had Nicole, and I had Tracy.
They all knew about each other?
Yeah.
And they were cool with that?
2 of them went to the same school.
And they were all cool with each other?
Nah, they wasn't cool with each other. They didn't get along.
Because I always wanted to ask, because you have how many baby mothers now?
5 or 6. Hold on. Six.
10 kids?
8.
8 kids?
Yeah. 3 for 1 girl.
3 from 1 girl?
Yeah.
They're cool with each other?
Yeah, they straight. They got problems with me. They ain't fighting each other.
Did they gang up on you?
They're like when they was, yeah, some of them, together.
Like they
form. Fucking right. Some of them form alliances now. But, you know, at first when we was young, when we was teenagers, they fought. But now everybody fucking get along. Everybody, it's just me. It's just me.
They fought before?
Yeah, they fought.
Actual fist fights?
Hell yeah. Fucking right. I'm my baby.
Wow.
Because I was playing games with a lot of them, you know. That's why they don't fight now. Because I don't sleep with none of my baby mamas. We're not.
You've said this before, and I was going to ask you about that. Why don't you sleep with any of your baby mamas?
I just feel like when you keep it business-wise, it can calm down. It can cut out a lot of problems.
And be tough.
And then I want to be a chef. But can you believe they want you to go to school for that? I was
wish I could find a man who could swoop in like a superhero and save me from, you know, work. Kind of like a captain saving me.
Do you know where I can buy a cape?
Damn.
Whoa.
Wow. Riley!
This is your home? It's beautiful. Hey, boys. I love this place. I never want to leave. Is there anything to eat?
I didn't want to believe Riley. I wanted Granddad to have finally found love in his life. But I've never been one to ignore the obvious. Granddad was trying to turn a hoe into a housewife.
You ain't saying nothing, little girl.
Come on, Granddad.
What you talking about? You just wait a minute.
Yeah. Before you start, I just want to tell you how much fun it's been hanging out with you guys. Think of me as the big sister you always wanted.
Don't take this the wrong way, but I need you to get the hell up out of here.
Any particular reason?
You're kind of a lazy hoe?
Yeah, I can see that.
I don't know why my granddad can't see it.
To be honest, me either. It's so obvious. But it's okay because, see, I'm in this transitional period.
I don't care. You gotta go.
I can't do that.
I'm sorry?
You guys have the life, and I want the life too.
Yeah, but it's our life. We're his family.
Oh, so now we get to what this is really about. I'm not one of y'all. I'm not in the family. I don't carry his genes. So I have to go?
Yeah. Plus you're a lazy hoe.
Hoe is a strong term. Right now I'm somewhere between anatomical sales associate and high maintenance girlfriend. Can't you be positive about my growth?
Crystal, every part of you being here is unacceptable. Do you realize I'm doing prostitute laundry? Do you have any idea how disgusting that is?
Look, this is an adjustment for everyone. But it's what your grandfather wants. You can't get rid of me. I can do things to persuade your granddad that you can't do.
Like what? Never mind, I don't really...
Cutie pie, what is this?
That's not me. I can't believe you would digitally alter pictures of me.
Boy, that ain't nothing but Photoshop. Get that out of here.
Why don't they like me? I try so hard with them.
Oh, there, there. Haven't I done enough for you two? Y'all don't know what it's like to be old. To know you don't have many days left. Crystal makes me happy. Why would you want to take that away from me?
My 9-year-old, 10-year-old, I showed all of them how to put on rubber. Before you even start having sex, I didn't show my sons how to put on rubber. I ain't finna get my son no motherfucking shit out here. I'm training them boys right. Ask any of my nephew, ask my son. Yeah. They were 12, 13, they got hit. Yeah. That's how it's supposed to be. Yeah. Hell yeah, I got my fucking son dick sucked. You fucking right. Yes, a grown woman. Grown, super grown. Super grown. Check this ass out. Checked all my nephews out, super grown. Is she grown? She checked me out. I know what the fuck she did to them. She checked me out that bitch.
Bend it over, pussy fat, pussy porn. Main bitches say they pussy good, pussy born. Had to tuck the toilet when I'm fucking uniform. True religion, dick, horse, dick, the unicorn.
Y'all mad I'm dancing on my son, but for why? Like, it's not like I'm forcing him or none of that. Like, trust and believe.
What happens, right?
What happened with what?
Really, she really hurt, though. She really...
I'ma talk...
Me and my sister hurt, too.
Wow.
I don't do that, you. I don't tell your mother
business. Just, I don't go out in the street and tell people okay, who you really are.
Mama, did you hear how he feel though? He say she be able to talk to you. You should be able to tell nobody what he say.
Yo, hey, man.
Mama, did your son hurt?
God.
Mama, did go hug your child? He hurt.
I'm hurt.
You hurt? Hello, you hurt?
He hurt.
Go blame that on your mama. Go blame that on your daddy. Go blame that on your mama and your daddy. I ain't do nothing to you. I'm your mother child. I'm your child.
Because I never let these people, man.
Hey, God. No son is hurt.
And I believe I may have misplaced some merchandise at this residence. There she is. Bitch, I hope you got the monies to cover this little vacation you've been taking.
Now hold up, Slickback.
No, that's a pimp named Slickback.
That's what I said, Slickback.
No, it's a pimp named Slickback. Like a Tribe Called Quest, you say the whole thing. A pimp named Slickback.
Can we call you Slickback for short?
No, nigga, I'm a pimp named Slickback.
Crystal, who is this person?
Nigga, are you deaf? I'm a pimp named Slickback. Say it with me now. Bitch, now!
People seem to not understand me. Yes, I call out white people for not understanding their privilege and not understanding that they live in a society that puts them systematically on the top. But don't get it wrong. I am still a white man's whore. If Timothy Chalamet were to come up to me and said, "Hey, I'm taking your virginity," I'm not asking any questions. I'm not giving any suggestions. I'm going to shut up, and I'm going to let that white man defile me. And I stand.